Hello and welcome to week 4. This is Ludmilla Adams from Fashion Chalkboard. Once again, this is the 52-week series, one tip for every week of the year, fashion design in Adobe Illustrator. The flat sketch, as always, is in the free member area of fashionchalkboard.com, so go ahead and download it if you want to follow along. And today you're going to learn how to create your custom gradient and how to rotate that gradient and how to really pick up the colors that you want inside of your gradient, how to blend them a little bit. The basic gradient is something that everybody kind of plays with, so that's what you have right there. And we're going to start right away with this no color shirt. To begin, I'm going to click on the center bodice right here and make sure the fill is on top and activate the basic gradient. The basic gradient usually activates your gradient window. If not, just go to window, gradient, make sure it pops up. And the basic gradient looks pretty boring. There's two gradient sliders going from black to white. And what we can do is actually activate one of these colors by clicking on it. When we click on it, we can change to the eyedropper tool. And it's still active. And we press down shift. And when we press down shift, we can press on the color and it'll apply it to that position. You can add more stops to this slider by pressing when you see the plus symbol right under here. And then once again, you can see how this one's active because it's shown with the black arrow on top. Press shift and click on the color. You can see how I now added a second position there. I'm gonna add a third position. I'm gonna add with shift this color into that box. Put that close over here. The white is actually too bright, so I'm going to make it a little bit softer by adding this color right there. Okay, so now we can switch to the gradient tool. And we can manually, on the side where you see the little diamond, rotate this by clicking and dragging. We can position this exactly where we want the dark part to be. And we can now, on the t-shirt, mix our colors by dragging these little boxes that we just added. We can rotate this a little bit more. And I want a little bit more white. So a little bit more dark parts, something like this. And then the great thing is we can click on our sleeve and with the eyedropper pick up that custom gradient that we just created. One of the things that I'd like you guys to double check is that in your eyedropper, so you double click on your eyedropper, that the appearance is checkmarked. If not, like I'm taking it out right now, if I am on my sleeve and I press on the gradient, it'll just do it at a 0 degree angle for the first time that you pick it up. Right there, part of the appearance, so let's check that. So now if I press on the gradient, it'll also pick up the angle. So let's make sure that that's happening. And we can style this a little bit further if we want. Go to your gradient tool on your sleeves, rotate that on the sleeves a little bit, if that's what you want. If you want to test out how that actually looks on a bigger piece, go ahead and pick up that gradient. Oops. Rotate that. And if you like this better, click on the sleeve and eyedrop. Have that rotation. And if you don't know how to do the opposite, you can right click, transform, reflect, copy, put that sleeve, and you have that perfect mirrored sleeve over there. Okay, so that concludes the little tip for today. Go ahead and use this hexagon to use the second color palette and see if you can achieve this effect that I created. And you can obviously take the one that I gave you guys apart and see what happened there. All right, thank you once again for watching. Subscribe to my channel, leave in the comments if you have any questions, and I'll see you guys next time.